Hello, Michelle. Welcome to the webinar on Vibrant Faith University. If you can hear me and you can click on the chat icon in the in your dashboard there, type in a message. Maybe tell me where you're from. You're the first one to show up, and we expect a number of others. So, welcome. All right, we have a few other people joining us for the webinar. Jan, Chris, and Kathy. If you look on your Webinar Jam dashboard, there's the opportunity for you to type in the chat box. Jan, I see your message from Cambridge, Ontario. Wonderful. Type in the chat box there, the rest of you, where you're from, and welcome anyway. I'm Leif Kerwald. I am both your host and your presenter today. So we've got our fingers crossed that there are no technical issues, because I'm not a techno whiz. I trust that you can hear me. If you have any questions or concerns, use the chat box, and I'll respond if I can. Chris from Boonville, Missouri, wonderful. Welcome. So I wonder if Kathy can hear us. I trust that you can, even though we, oh, there you are, Kathy. Wonderful. So welcome. We've got a few minutes yet before the webinar begins, and I'll do some of this introduction again as more people chime in. It's sort of like when you board an airplane. If you board early, you hear some of the announcements several times. Welcome. Just so you know, I'm based in Portland, Oregon, where today it's not cold in the 50s, but windy, real windy and wet. Our rainy season has definitely arrived. Okay, while we're waiting, I'll play a little music, and then I'll touch base with you again soon. Thank you. Once again, welcome folks to the webinar introduction to Vibrant Faith University. We'll get started in just a few minutes. We have a number of people with us, but we are expecting more. So we'll wait a couple moments. Notice though, as you're waiting, in your Webinar Jam dashboard, there's an icon for chat. And if you click on that chat, you can type in, I see most of you have typed in where you're from. And if for some reason you can't hear me, please let me know that, or if you're having any kind of trouble at all. Early on in the chat, I typed in my email address. If you run into trouble, send me an email. I would give you my phone number, but we're going to start the webinar in just a moment, and I won't be able to answer the phone. If for some reason there are issues that you are experiencing, I will definitely get back to you after we get done, and I will make sure you get the information that we covered today. So again, welcome. Give a couple moments and we'll get going. Notice in the chat box that Chris used the question icon. So if you go down near the bottom on the dashboard, on the left-hand side, just left of the chat box, the text box itself, there's an option to choose chat, or if you click on the little arrow, you have the option to ask a question. Keep that in mind as we go through our session this morning. If you have a particular question that you want to ask, use the question mark if possible, and that will cue me that there's a question there. Chris, just to respond to your question about Do What Matters, for those of you who don't know, that was the two-day workshop series that we conducted in, about 30 sites around the country this year in 2015. And essentially, Chris, that was our 2015 workshop series. We are concluding that workshop series with an online version of Do What Matters, scheduled for January 12th and January 14th, a Tuesday and a Thursday. And there's information online about that. Otherwise, the Do What Matters programs that we will be doing in 2016 are those at the invitation of local area judicatories or dioceses or clusters of churches. So instead of Vibrant Faith sponsoring, it will be local area sponsoring. So if that's something that you're interested in, I'm happy to talk with you about that. All right, we're getting close to our start time. So we will begin in just a few moments, and I will, in the meantime, like I said, invite you to chime in on the chat box. Let me know where you're from. Okay, just one more announcement about the chat box and then we'll get going. As as we go through, if you have a question, the way today's webinar is going to work is I'm actually going to play a video of a presentation that I made about Vibrant Faith University just a couple weeks ago that gives all the general details, and then we'll engage in conversation and question after that. So near the chat box, near the text box at the bottom of your Webinar Jam dashboard, you can change that text bubble to, or that chat bubble to, a question mark, if you have questions. But of course, as we go along, your comments are welcome in the chat box. So let's begin. My name is Leif Kerwald. I come to you from Portland, Oregon. I work with Vibrant Faith, and Vibrant Faith is the sponsoring organization of Vibrant Faith University. That's the focus of our conversation today. I'm the partner for training services. So all of the things that we do with respect to training church leaders in all the areas of faith formation stability. Today, I'm flying solo to do this webinar. Typically, our partner for digital services, Jared Rundell, is with me, and he serves as the producer, if you will. But Jared's wife, Anna, just had a baby a few days ago, and so they're busy about things that are much more important. I welcome you, and as I said a few minutes ago, if for some reason you experience any kind of problems with today's webinar, don't get the information, or it doesn't come through for some reason, let me know, and I will connect with you personally about that. So, let's jump in. I want to share with you, as I said, a video that describes Vibrant Faith University in some detail. The video is about 12 minutes long, so we'll all just sit and watch that, and then as the video goes, though, type in your questions or your comments as you go, and then we'll take 15 minutes or so, or however long you wish, to chat about it, and I'm happy to respond to your questions. So, Vibrant Faith University, let's see, share my screen. I want to begin by saying it's pretty clear to us, and I think it's clear to you, that churches today need a new way to do faith formation for all ages, across the life cycle, across the lifespan, that is not based on outdated assumptions, but rather recognizes the realities of 21st century people today. It's clear we need a new model of faith formation in order to transmit faith to the next generation. And so with that in mind, I want to share my screen. I want to take you to the webpage, vibrantfaith.org-vfu, the Vibrant Faith University page. And I simply want to say that we have designed Vibrant Faith University around this desire to create a whole new ecosystem of faith formation. And it's anchored in six particular characteristics. First, a sense that it has to take on an intergenerational quality, intergenerational context. It recognizes the power of parents and home in faith formation. It addresses the unique needs of age groups. So age segmentation is still a part of this ecosystem, but not the center part that it has occupied in the last couple of generations. It must develop a missional outreach to those who are on the fringes, uninvolved, unaffiliated, and it must be digitally enabled. We must make good use of our digital tools, and we must go to the digital places where people hang out. So it's these five things plus a key component that essentially you bring. This ecosystem calls for an innovative, collaborative, forward-thinking set of leaders who are committed to faith formation in the 21st century. And we see that as you,
or you along with us in partnership. So Vibrant Faith University presents a new vision, a new set of practices anchored in the most recent research and the most recent resources available to us. We're so grateful to have John Roberto working with us in this process, because there's nobody in the world who does curation of resources better than John. And so we have designed a new learning model that will immerse you into a rich and creative learning environment that includes such things as online live presentations from our cadre of nationally known experts in the field of faith formation, mixed in with self-paced online learning, mixed in with a good solid online learning community. So this won't be an isolated experience for you. In fact, with each cohort, there will be a learning guide that will meet with you one-to-one and invite you into small group consultation with other learnings along the way. So you might ask, okay, who is Vibrant Faith University for? It is for leaders who care about the future of faith formation. Whether you are a full-time, part-time, or volunteer ministry leader, you may be a pastor or a Christian education director or faith formation coordinator of children, youth, family, or any number of other ministry leadership roles. If you want to guide your faith community in embracing this 21st century approach to faith formation, we believe Vibrant Faith University is for you. We call it applied learning. Everything that you do, all your coursework, is designed to be applied directly to your ministry setting. Each course has immediate applications. In fact, a great deal of your coursework will also be your workwork, your parish work. And when you emerge a couple years down the line as a Vibrant Faith University graduate, you will have in hand, if not already in implementation, a comprehensive and dynamic plan for effective faith formation. Because you will have learned how to translate the best research into approaches, practices, and resources. Your congregation will have become intentionally intergenerational. You will be prepared for the changing religious landscape of the 21st century. You will be introduced to new models, tools, resources, approaches that recognize the diverse religious and spiritual needs of people today. And you will have been empowered to develop a missional approach to reach out to people where they are today in their home, their work, and their community. So those six key factors that I shared with you earlier correspond directly to the six courses. So picture it this way: over a two-year period, six courses. Each course is 15 weeks long. Like I said, I'll take you to a picture of one of the courses in just a moment. But just to list them, the courses are forming that faith-forming culture in the congregation. Two, intergenerational faith formation. Three, family faith formation. Four, age group faith formation. Five, missional faith formation. And six, leading faith formation for the 21st century. Each course follows a similar pattern. Three, over the course of the course, three online learning sessions live with your instructors. And mixed in between those are self-paced learning sessions with lots of application to your ministry setting. You'll be introduced to and invited to read some terrific books, as well as articles and podcasts and the rest, to accentuate your learning. And all of that takes place in the in the learning platform. And finally, I mentioned each course will have a learning guide where you'll have one-to-one and small group consultation. This is an online learning experience. You don't have to travel, but we are committed to surrounding you with personalized support as opposed to an isolated online learning experience. So let me take you to the platform that we're using. The learning management system is called CourseSites, which is powered by Blackboard, an incredibly robust learning management system. Blackboard is used in many colleges and universities all across the country, and CourseSites offers all the same tools for learning that are available in Blackboard. So I'm on our first course, Reimagining Faith Formation. Over here on the left side is the dashboard that helps me journey through the course week by week. Starts with course overview. When I click on that, I'm given the page that gives me all of the information that I need to get going in this course. And you see that laid out here. So this is good orientation. And as you can see in the dashboard, we've laid out the course on a weekly basis. We envision that you would spend 2.5 to 3 hours a week engaged in your coursework with Vibrant Faith University. About an hour of reading each week, and then study and other work that you do. And so each week is laid out in steps. Like this very first week has four steps: act, discuss, read, watch, and learn. So let me take you inside that. Start with the first part, act. We invite you to do this activity called Shape of the World. The video down here would give some brief instructions on how to do the activity. And then I click on the activity itself. The worksheet pops up here. I complete the worksheet, and then I go back and I am invited to do the discuss. That's part two. In effect, there's a couple of discussion questions that I engage with my fellow classmates about this activity. So I click through to the discussion forum. Here are the questions. I click on reply, and there you go. Step three in week one is the reading assignments. Two different reading assignments for that week, shown here. And then finally, the last step of week one is essentially the lecture material, if you will, and that there are three parts. First of all, the slides, and I can click through and look at the slides that are presented. The idea is read through those first and then view the two videos where, in this case, John Roberto leads us through those slides in looking at the material for this week. So that's a look at 1 week of Vibrant Faith University learning. That is self-paced learning in that week. I want to take you to another week that shows two things that are crucial or that I'd like to share with you. Week three has two things that are helpful. An assignment. I want to show you what an assignment looks like. So in this case, and typically each course will have two assignments that you're responsible for. I click through on this assignment, and it's to complete the Vibrant Faith Congregational Assessment Tool. So that's available to me here. Here's the tool. I would complete the assessment. It's just one page. I may even give it to other leaders in my congregation to get more data. That would be helpful to do as well. Then I come back and I view the short video that helps me interpret the assessment. That's this video here. And then for the actual to complete the assignment, I respond to the questions that are listed here. How do I do that? Well, I scroll down and I have the option to write my responses to those questions in this text box, or I can write them on in another document and attach that as an attached file. So that's the quick look at course sites, and one of our courses in the learning platform. So I just want to go back here and simply point out that we believe that in partnership with you, Vibrant Faith University can really change the face of how faith formation is done in the 21st century. Think of it this way. Your commitment is 2 years. The learning that you gain will last your whole life, and the application of your learning in your ministry setting could last through the generations. I simply cannot think of a better way to spend a couple thousand dollars.
Okay, so that's the end of that video, and
we have designed Vibrant Faith University around this desire to create a whole new ecosystem of faith formation.
Forgive me there. All right, so wondering what your questions might
be. It's anchored in 6 particular characteristics. First, a sense that it...
Too many buttons to push, too many screens to look at. Judy, can you give some more details on the course projects and how we submit them? Yes, to some degree, but quite frankly, we're still working that through. Here's the idea: is that the assignments in each of the 2 courses are designed to be very very much applied learning, so applied to your ministry setting. So in course 1, that first assignment really is an assessment, taking a look at how faith formation is done in our church in light of this vision, this picture of a faith formation ecosystem around those 5 components that I described in the video. And then part 2, your assignment will be to begin, and again, I'm sorry, I can't be more articulate than this, but we're still designing the assignment so that it will be clear to you. But what we want you to do is, in effect, choose a particular area of among those 5, whether it's intergenerational, family, or home, being more digitally enabled, etc., and begin designing some plans around how your faith formation effort can go after that particular arena, and you'll design some plans and strategies and programs, and then part of the I mentioned in that video there's 3 online learning sessions that are live. The 3rd online learning session is an opportunity for students to share the plans and ideas that they've put together in that particular assignment. So that's the pattern that we envision throughout all of the 6 courses, because then by the end of the 6 courses, you will have been able to really design that full-blown ecosystem of faith formation in your ministry setting. I hope that helps, and I can certainly share more detail with you as it comes through. Other thoughts, other questions that you might have? I noticed in the video that I failed to show you some of the information about the 3 online live learning sessions. So most of the work that you do is self-paced on your own, using course sites, but I want to go back and see if I can share with you the at least the notation of where we are with I can't do three things at once. I want to show you the online learning session and the information, but let me respond to Jan's question first. How will the small groups be configured? Really good question there, Jan, and there's lots of options. What we have planned is that each class of 25 or 30 students will have one or two cohort guides, and the guide is available to you, someone with experience in faith formation that will invite you into a small group conversation. And this can be done according to your schedule. In other words, the guide may set up small group conversations that occur once, twice, or three times in a given week, and you choose the time that's suited best for you, and that essentially becomes your small group. The other option, and this is one that we're encouraging, at least in a regional basis, we're in conversation with a number of judicatories that are interested in sponsoring Vibrant Faith University, or bringing a small cohort of students to one of our classes, one of our national programs. And if that were the case, then you would have a local cohort guide, someone selected from your area that you may be able to meet with face to face, or in a small group of fellow students from your area. So that's how that's shaping up. Judy, if we miss a live session, can we watch it again some other time? Yes, all of the online live sessions will be recorded, just like this webinar is being recorded, and they will be available to you, and you will be encouraged to go back to them, review some of the things that were said, etc. It becomes a good resource for everyone in the course. But we do, and you'll see in the material that we do say the online learning session is required. In other words, we really want you there so that you have some experience with your instructor, some interchange around the material. Okay, let me try to go back to course sites and see what I can share with you. This is the screen that I wanted. Okay. I wanted to, excuse me for, let me just expand this a little bit. One thing that did not show up in the video, over here on week three, I showed you an assignment, yes, but I wanted to also show you just what you'll see in course sites when it comes time for one of these online live sessions. So we're in week three, and the invitation is to attend. And this page simply gives the information about the online live session that will occur on January 27th at 1 p.m. Eastern Time, 10 a.m. Pacific Time, and a little bit about the session, and then the connection information for how students will essentially log into a webinar just like what you've done today. So that's what I wanted to show you there. Okay. Other comments, other questions that you might have. I can share with you that our first cohort, our first class of students is coming online now. The first class is about half full, and they begin their work on January 11th, 2016. We will likely close off registration, if you will, probably a week before that, probably in that very first week of January. Michelle, good question. Will most of the live sessions be during the day, or will there be evening options? Currently, what we imagine is daytime sessions. But if it turns out that a lot of people cannot make them during the daytime, then we'll make adjustments. We have to recognize that we are spanning at least four time zones in this country, and there is interest in this from various parts of the world as well. So, good question. Something that I'll keep in mind and that I'll take back to our team. And Michelle, I wonder if what's implied behind your question is that you perhaps would not be available during the day. Is that correct? Jan, if my ministry context changes during the course, will it still work? Yes. In short, what you'll learn in this process will be applicable to faith formation ministry wherever you go and whatever you're doing. So even if you do year one in one ministry setting and you've done some application to that, those strategies that you've employed can also be redeployed in your new ministry setting as you move through. So you'll gain lots of knowledge, lots of experience, and you can always take that with you wherever you go, whether you're still in the process of working through the 2 years of Vibrant Faith University or even after that. Judy, for the projects, can we continue on the same one in the entire year, or do we have to do a new one for each of the six courses? I love your questions, Judy, because you're thinking along the same lines that we have. We want to design these course projects in such a way that they build on one another. So in effect, you are doing six distinct pieces of one big project that is forming this faith formation ecosystem in your setting. So they are not separate. They will dovetail. They will integrate with one another and be successive, building one on the other. In that context, you'll want to be in dialogue with us, your course instructors, about where you want to take this. We will lay out for you this big picture of a faith-forming ecosystem for the congregation, but the particular expression of that is going to be in your hands and in the hands of the people that you work with in your ministry setting. All right, we promised that that this would be a 30-minute webinar, and we're down to the bottom of the hour, so our time has expired, but I'll stick around for a little while. I'm gonna stop the broadcast in just a moment, so you won't be able to hear me, but I'll stick around with the chat box if there are more things that, questions and things that you have. I'm also going to type here in the chat box my phone number. This is my direct line, and very happy to talk with you about this at any time. And my email was further up or down in the chat box. So feel free to communicate with me there. By the way, one last thought. The video that I showed you is online on the Vibrant Faith University page. So vibrantfaith.org/VFU. You can view that video again if you wish. All right then, thank you all very much for being here today. I know that it takes a little bit of thinking about the time and the money with respect to something like this. It's quite an investment of both. And I know that there are people that you have to talk to about that. But I do want to say that it's very clear to me that our first cohort, our first class will definitely fill up. So you don't want to procrastinate if you want to be part of our first course. So thank you. Good to be with you.